Hello everyone, welcome to the Engineering Projects YouTube channel. In this video tutorial I will tell you about how to write Excel file in C# programming language. The following C# code example show how to use interop to create an Excel file. Before going to create new Excel file programmatically in C#, you must have Excel installed in your system for this code to run properly. To access the object model from Visual C#.net, you have to add Microsoft Excel 15.0 object library to your project. Create a new project in your Visual Studio and add a command button to your C form. From the following picture, you can find how to add Excel reference library in your project. Select Add Reference dialog from project menu of your Visual Studio, and in the COM tab add Microsoft Excel 15.0 object library. First we have to initialize the Excel application object excel.application. The name of the application as XL app is equal new microsoft.office.interop.excel.application. Before creating new Excel workbook, you should check whether Excel is installed in your system or not. If XL app double equal null, then message will show Excel is not installed properly, else return. Then create a new workbook. XL workbook is equal XL app dot workbook dot add miss value. After creating new workbook, next step is to write content to worksheet. XL worksheet is equal XL dot worksheet parsing them. XL workbook dot worksheet dot get underscore item one. It's mean the page one of the Excel file or the sheet one. XL worksheet dot cell 1, 1 mean one first row first column is equal write ID, then Excel worksheet cell 1, 2 mean first row second column name, and so on. We are going to add values inside them, such as in second row first column 1, second row second column one, and same so on. In above code we write the data in sheet 1. If you want to write data in sheet 2, then you should code like this and replace get underscore item from 1 to 2. Next is save Excel file as save as method. After write the content into the cell, next step is to save the Excel file in your system. Excel workbook dot save as the file name. Interop marshaling governs how data is passed in method arguments and return value between managed and unmanaged memory during calls. Most data type have common representation in both managed and unmanaged memory. The interop marshals handle these type for you. Other type can be ambiguous or not represented at all in managed memory, such as marshal.releaseCom object XLWB, marshal.releaseCom object XLApp. It is important to note that every reference to an XLCom object had to be set to null when we have finished with it, including cell, sheet, everything. The Marshall clause is in the system.runtime.interop services namespace, so you should import the following namespace using system.runtime.interop services. Now create an Excel spreadsheet programmatically. Here is the code. First we have create an app then check is Excel is installed or not. Create a workbook, create a worksheet. Now we create the miss object, system.reflection.missing.values. Now pass the miss value to the Excel workbook and Excel worksheet, parsing them Excel worksheet, Excel workbook dot worksheet dot get underscore item one. It means we have selected Excel sheet one. Now we are going to add values as I have explained. Excel workbook dot save as, here is the path of the Excel file which we are going to save. Excel dot file format dot Excel workbook normal, the normal format of Excel 5. Miss value, these miss values are replaced by these references. And Excel save access mode dot Excel exclusive, and the miss values are replaced by the other null values. Excel workbook dot close, we have closed the Excel sheet and app is quit here. And we are going to release the all object, or you can replace them with the null. Marshall dot release com object Excel worksheet workbook and Excel app. This message will pop up and show that the Excel type file is created. So here is the folder, there is no file is present. Now we'll execute the program. It take a while and create the Excel file. So Excel file is created. Now we can go here and check, and here is the Excel file sheet data, sheet 1. If you want to enter the data in sheet 2, what you have to do, just simply change this 1 to 2 and execute it again. The same data will be printed on sheet 2. Yes, okay. And you can see the data is not in sheet 1 but on sheet 2. So I hope this video tutorial is informative for you. If you have any kind of question, you can ask us.